Hello everyone, Delicates here, and welcome back to some more Pokemon Yellow. No matter last time, we have pretty much walked our way around Survive Zone to get the Golden Tooth and get the TM Surf from the Secret House and for the warning for this Golden Tooth. Now, we are back in Vermilion City. We actually are going to hit Route 11, 12, and 13, 14, 15 in this episode, because if you guys do remember that we could have went this way to Lavender Town or to Fosia City. I'm actually looking for my bicycle right quick. There it is. Okay. We're just gonna make this process a whole lot more quicker. Cause the last time we actually went through here around the time when we was in Vermilion when we managed to get Squirtle. We had to take Diglett Cave here, but we actually gonna go this way. There's gonna be some trainers up here. Just gonna do some training, and that plus also we do have another Snorlax that we do need to wake up actually. So let's go, but don't cheat. We actually did forget about those board keepers at the end of the cycling. The Cycling World Gatehouse, but I'm not too worried about them right now. Whenever we get back to Fleon City before we actually head back to before we start heading to Calabar Island, I'm not gonna be too worried about them. Alright. That's not right. Thank you for the 315 Pokédollars. I really forget, like, all of these Pokemons over here are gonna be low level actually. So let's just want to swap out Pikachu here, because all these trainers we could have hit up like way earlier in the series. That's why I just became a trainer, but I think I can win. I've been in training for a little bit actually, so just let you know, youngster. We haven't fired youngster in a minute. Alright, he has a Sandshrew. I feel like we actually have a different move, but I don't think, yeah. None of our electric types can do anything to the Sandshrew, so it looks like it was a bad idea to get Pikachu in the front of the party right now, but we're gonna bring out Venusaur here. It's just Razor Leaf. I'm probably gonna one-shot this Sandshrew, actually. Beautiful Venusaur. Beautiful. It was super effective. Sandshrew disbanded and Pikachu just gained 186 experience points, the same as Venusaur. He has Zubat to escape Venusaur out, actually. Pretty much all of our Pokemon are pretty much equal. I think Kimberly just a slight bit lower of a level, to be honest. Because everybody else is like 36, 37, 38, close to 40, level 40. So we still don't really have much of a. I'm surprised that Razor Leaf did not. One solid to Zubat. Well, we're gonna use Divine Will. Let's go ahead and faint this Zubat here. Our Venusaur just gained 219 experience points. We're gonna get a whole lot more low experience points because these are a whole lot more lower Pokemon trainers here. We got 285 Pokedollars. We get a gambler here. Win, lose, or draw. I'm surprised there actually is a gambler here because they're more closer to Celebon City, actually. He has a Poliwag. Well, lucky for us, we can actually use Pikachu against this water type Pokemon, the Poliwag. One shot Poliwag. Pikachu's gained 297 experience points, and he probably gonna have a. Oh, he has a Horsey. Okay, that's not really much of a problem, to be honest. Let's use Thunderbolt on this Horsey. Beautiful. It was super effective. Horsey just fainted and Pikachu just gained 319 experience points. Ugh. Didn't go my way. Got 1,260 Pokedollars. There's a lot of trainers like scattered out Route 11 here. Got a Pidgey. We don't really need to train because none of my Pokemons are like low level, to be honest. I've got I think this is a youngster. My Pokemon should be ready by now. There is another gambler too I liked. Yeah, it's a youngster. I feel like this is gonna be all youngsters. I got a Delaware male here. Hi, Pikachu. Stunned about this Delaware male. Just gonna do some training today. That's pretty much all we're gonna do. Pikachu just gained 231 experience points. That plus also we do get money also. I gotta get a remote. This is pretty much the male version here. States to the Delaware. Alright, then we know it's raining and Pikachu just gained 454 experience points. Too much too young. Thank you for the 270 Pokedollars, youngster. Alright, we got a gambler here. Competition, I can't get enough. I'm gonna make sure we actually do hit up every single trainer though. Alright, gambler, what do you got? You got a bell spell. Alright. We haven't seen a bell spell in a minute. It's just Thunderbolt. I know it's not gonna be really effective against grass types, but well, it's gonna one-sided, that's fine. It was a critical hit, but it's not really effective because it was electric. Alright, Bell Spout just banned it, and we just Pikachu just gained 324 experience points. Yeah, but Oddis. Yeah, let's keep Pikachu out. We're trying to get the experience for Pikachu here. Okay. It was not effective, but Oddis still got paralyzed from that Thunderbolt, actually. I was about to say Thunderstorm for a second. It was not really effective, but it did faint at the Oddis, and Pikachu gained 300 experience points. I had a chance. Thank you for the 1260 Pokedollars, gambler. We do appreciate that. Alright, we got another gambler here. I'm going to head up here. I have never won before. You never won before? I feel like you just need to stop gambling dude. If you haven't won before, you're just gonna lose a lot of money. Right, you gotta go live. Okay, yeah, let's keep Pikachu out. Just Thunderbolt the crap of this Growlithe here. Just one-sided. Growlithe just painted and Pikachu's gained 351 experience points. We got a Vulpix. Yeah, let's keep Pikachu out. I'm surprised we have not went into a Ninetales yet. It probably will when we get to Silvan Island though. Pikachu just gained 243 experiment points by finding that Vulpix. Alright, cool. Thank you, gambling man. I saw this coming. Thank you for the 1260 Pokedollars. I really do appreciate that. Alright, see if there's anything in the middle here. Yeah, there was a trainer here. Careful, I'm laying down some cables. I'm putting cables down in the middle of a... Oh, it's the engineer. Ah, you must be working on something. You must be working on the... Working on the sidewalk. Alright, some Magnite. It's not gonna be really, really effective, but we're gonna keep Pikachu out of use Thunderbolt. One-sided? That was a critical hit, but not really offended. Mega Knight is gonna use Tackle. Okay. Actually, Himalayan is actually a level 36. Yeah, let's actually swap out Himalayan here. Okay, Mega Knight is gonna use Sonic Boom. Let's use Double Kick. I just made it. And Pikachu just gained 198 experience points, the same as Himalayan. That was electric. Thank you for the 1050 Pokedollars, engineer. You can continue working on the sidewalk here. I got a youngster, I believe. Watch out for live wires. Battler is by another engineer. Is it not an engineer? Okay. What are they doing all the way out this way? If they working on the new Wild Spore. Okay. Let's out Hitmonlee. I feel like Hitmonlee, Venusaur, and Pikachu still needs to do more training. Now, man, we did a pretty good amount back in the Cycling World episode, but we didn't really get a lot of experience for Hitmonlee, Venusaur, and Pikachu. Mostly Pikachu, though. Pikachu just gained 169 experience points, and Hitmonlee did too. I have another Magnite. Let's keep Hitmonlee out. Let's just continue doing double kill. These are so low level Pokemon. Hitmonlee just gained 342 experience points. And he has a Magnetine, so that is saving the best for last. Now let's do double kill. Once out of it, but that's fine. It's fine. Alright, Hitmonlee just gained 621 experience points. Ooh, you spark plugged. Thank you for the 900 Poké Dollars, Engineer. We do appreciate that. Hey, ooh, there's a Gimlet just in the bush there. I did not see him. He's actually was hidden. Bahaha, I have never lost. Well, you're gonna lose this time, Gambling Man. Just letting you know. Two Pokemon, you're probably gonna be a Voltorb. Alright, Pikachu. We're still done to suck this Voltorb. We could just one-shot it. Beautiful, Pikachu. Beautiful. It's not really effective, but that is fine. We did one-shot it this Voltorb. Pikachu just gained it 396 experience points. And Pikachu just leveled up to level 36. Guess I got a Magnite. That is fine. Yeah, but Zeus is on the boat. Let's keep Pikachu out on the field. It's not really affected. That's fine. I wasn't really expecting to get one-shotted it, but I was more than expecting to be one-shotted the Magnite, but I'm honestly surprised it didn't. Alright, it was not really affected, but that is fine. We just painted the Magnite, Pikachu's gaining 342 experience points. My first lost. Oh well, thank you for the 1,260 Pokédollars. I actually do think we actually just get that amount of Pokédollars for each Gambling Man, actually. It's just been 1,260 Pokédollars, pretty much. Oh, we got a trainer here. I am the best in my class. There are actually some more trainers through here. That's fine. Alright, we got a youngster. He has three Pokémon. We got a Rattata. It's probably gonna be all Rattatas. It's probably gonna be a Raticate in this, also. Let's actually swap him out for Pikachu out to Hitmonlee, because Pikachu only got like one more Thunderbolt on power points left. So we're probably gonna keep it for something really, really special, to be honest. It was a critical hit, it was super effective. Rattata just fainted, and Pikachu's gaining 102 experience points, and same as Hitmonlee. We've got another Rattata. Let's do Skullbass. It's a new move, actually. We got it in the last episode. Rattata using Tackle. It's a critical hit. And Rattata's using Quick Attack. I'm using Skullbass. Can we one-shot it? Beautiful. Rattata just fainted, and Hitmonlee just gained 207 experience points. It's Eradicate. Yep, I was right. I was right, guys. I knew it was gonna be Eradicate in this. Alright, let's use the Thunderbolt on this Eradicate here. We can just one-sided. Beautiful, Pikachu. Beautiful. Eradicate just gained and Pikachu just gained 421 experience points. Darn, I need to make my Pokemon stronger. Thank you for the 255 Pokédollars, Sangster. Alright, let's go up this way. I think we already got that Gambling Man. Alright, let's go over here and see if there's anything over here. I'm actually surprised there's actually no items. Oop! We got a Scape up in this bush here. Alright, cool. Let's go through the gatehouse. If you guys remembered, That there is a Snorlax here. Now we do have the Puka Flute. We can go ahead and look at the Snorlax. This is actually the second one. No matter, we did try to catch that Snorlax back in the Cycling World episode, but we've kind of failed. But this is our second attempt. We can do that now. I'm actually curious if we can actually can catch it, but I don't really want to kill it. It is a Snorlax. We didn't really have been catching a lot of Pokemon lately. The only way, does that affect Snorlax? Really? How am I going to do some damage without one-shotting? Well, Pikachu just fainted. Alright, yeah, so it's actually swapped to Venusaur. We see we can actually poison Snorlax. I think that'd be best to do. Alright, Snorlax just been poisoned. Alright, Snorlax gonna use Headbutt. We don't want to kill the Snorlax. Let's use Carp. If we do, okay, that's actually a pretty good amount of damage actually. They can continue using Cut. That plus poison's gonna make it a whole lot more easier to catch also. Alright, Snorlax is in the orange. Yeah, that's one thing about Snorlax. He can go to sleep and also heal himself up. We're not gonna use the Master Ball. I'm gonna leave the Master Ball alone. I thought I got some Ultra Balls! Oh no! We can't catch it, man. Oh no. Shoot. I forgot we didn't have no Ultra Balls actually. That kinda sucks. Well, I guess we're gonna use Mobby Vibe on Pikachu here. If you guys do remember back when we was in Labrador Town, we did came from... Let me heal up Hitmonlee here. Okay, we did came from this direction. Because pretty much this direction does take you to Lavender Town. And this way can take you to Flusia City. Pretty much that's where pretty much we're going to be heading to now. The sport fishing... So now we managed to go this way. We've got a lot of fishermen this way. Electrocution is my specialty. Don't think this is actually a fisherman, but there is a lot of fishermen. Yeah, we got a locker here. We got a Voltorb. Can't really do any damage with Pikachu right now, because all Pikachu has is Agility, Flash, and Thunder Wave. So we may have to swap him up to Hitmonlee actually. I feel like we may need to find like some moves so we can actually cheat Pikachu actually. I was used double kick on this Voltorb and Voltorb just fainted and Pikachu just gained 316 experience points, the same as him only. He has Electrorb. Yeah, but keep on him. We need to watch double self-destruct because he can do that. Our Master Spice is not using self-destruct, he's using Sonic Boom. Double kick. These are more higher level Pokemon now. He was going to use Squeaks, but it failed. Alright, beautiful. Electro just been fainted and Himalayan just gained 931 experience points. Unplugged. Thank you for the 725 Pokedollars, actually. Alright, Pikachu. I like you to be in the front, but we may swap out with Himalayan. That's what we're gonna do. We've got a house here. Got a bug catcher. I'm a fishing guru, brother. I simply love fishing. Do you like fishing? We just managed to get the good ward. Back in the last episode, actually. Now it looks like we're actually about to get the super ward here. Yep, we got the super ward. Now we pretty much got all the fishing wards, actually. We can always, toss the old wad and the good wad into the PC actually. It's actually the good wad is actually really, really good if you want to go back to like around the rock tunnel area around the power plant, because Nomad will be heading that direction at the end of the game, actually, because we have some legendaries we can catch also, because in the power plant you can actually manage to catch Zapdos, actually. Let's use the super wide. See if we can get anything crazy. Not even a nibble. Because I do know, like, super wide is actually supposed to be, like, really, really good if you want to catch, like, a DOT or something like that. Mostly around that area. But we got a bite, finally. Let's actually see what it is. It's probably something insane, actually. Seedra. That's kind of interesting, actually. We don't have no Pokeballs to catch it, though, but we can always train out here with the Seedra. Okay. It hit the enemy 2 times. Seedra's gonna use a bubble. Alright, Himalayan speed failed. Alright, let's use strength. Seedra's gonna use smoke screen. That's probably gonna bring down its activity. Yes, actually. Alright, come on, Seedra. You can chill out with this smoke screen, actually. I'll be using strength. Alright, Seedra just fainted. And Hitmonlee just gained 775 experience points. Alright, beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Alright, I'm actually surprised there's no fishermen's, but we do have a bush here we can cut, and also we do have, looks like it's a hiker actually. You never know what you could catch. I'm actually just here for the item. I think you are a hiker. No, you actually are not. You're actually a fisherman. It's a Magikarp. If I did have Pikachu out, we could have just won some of these Magikarps, but the only thing that Magikarp learns, it's a Splash. Because I think it only learned Splash for like a certain amount of levels, actually. This was a level 24, I'm surprised it didn't about to gel those, though. Himalayas just gained 102 experience points. I got another Magikarp. What level you are? You should be way above. You should have like a Gyarados. You actually could have had 2 Gyaradoses actually. Alright. Magikarp just ran in, we just gained 102 experience points. That is fine. Alright, lost it. Thank you for the 800 for the Pokedollars actually. It's an Iron. Alright, cool. That's actually really, really good. I think Iron's actually good for our defense. She's on Pikachu. Yes, defense for Iron. Alright, let's cut this bush down. We didn't get nothing too insane on that. Alright, we get a trainer here. Have you found a Moonstone? Actually, I found 3 actually. I had 3 in the PC in the Pokemon Center. Junior Trainer Mail. We got a Diddlewing Mail here. I feel like we could heal up Himalayan, but I'm pretty sure we'll probably be fine, actually. The geek's not really affected, but it did drop its health a good amount, actually. Alright, Dillowin's using Double Kick. Lucky for us, Double Kick doesn't really affect us that much either. And we should strength. Beautiful. Dillowin! Mail just fainted. Himalayan just gained 372 experience points, and Himalayan just leveled up to level 37. There you go, Dino we know. Yeah, let's actually swap it out with Venusaur, actually. Hi, Venusaur. This way, so leave this Dino we know. Critical hit. Dillowino's usually poison sting. It's a critical hit, but not really effective. We should use Razor Leaf one more time to be able to fight this Dillowino. Critical hits. Beautiful. Alright, Dealerino to Spain and Venusaur just gained 732 experience points. Ow. Well, thank you for the 580 Poké Dollars. I really do appreciate it. Alright, there's no training that way. I was just continuing going through the bridge. Oh, God bless you. I feel like this is just like a squirrel area, I believe. We'll get a junior channel female here. I found carbons in the cave ones. That's actually good for your speed, actually. Junior trainer female. We got a Goldeen. I'm actually surprised there's actually no crystal mats throughout these bridges where the ocean's at, actually. It's actually really suck, actually. We just one-shotted this Goldeen with double kick and him only just gained. Uh oh, that's a bad number. Experience points. Uh oh. Alright, we got a Poliwag here. Yeah, let's keep him on the elf. 666 experience points. The bad number, essentially. I probably just fainted and him only just gained 462 experience points. And Horsey is the last. Oh, we just used. Oh, we were just using strength, not double kick. My bad. My bad, my bad. Himalayas gained 498 experience points by fighting that horsey. Just messed up. Thank you for the 560 Poké Dollars. I don't think there's actually any trainers through here. Through this. I think it's just like a little area of grass, actually. But let's actually cut this little tree here and see. Yeah, it was just a little area of grass, actually. I was right. Luckily, I'm actually surprised we went to battle though. We didn't really have to cut the bush. We got Venus a youngster here. My bird Pokemon wants to stop. I think you are a bookkeeper, actually. Yep, you are a bookkeeper. Got your Pokeballs to get a Pidgey. Hi, Emily. Let's double kick this Pidgey. The other one started it, but that's fine. We just got one more kick in. It's not really effective, but we did fainted it. Pikachu. what the crap am I saying? Hit only just gained 340 experience points. I need to get a PTO toe. Alright, let's get Hit only out. Alright, let's use strength. PTO is gonna use quick attack. Low on the health, we do need to heal up Himalayan here. Could have one solid it just by a little bit, Himalayan, but that is fine. It's taking time, Himalayan. Alright, PTO just painted and Himalayan just gained 702 experience points. I don't know where I got Pikachu from. My bullet combo lost. Thank you for the 725 Poké Dollars, actually. Let's go ahead and heal up Himalayan while we think about it. The reason why I'm actually going through this, through these routes now is because these routes are actually really good for training, actually. No matter, it's kind of a little, it kind of can be a little hard if your Pokemon is not in good levels and doesn't really have much medicine. If your Pokemon's are really good levels and you have medicine, these four routes can be easy peasy. We just one-shotted the PG. Emily just gained 282 experience points. We got a Meowth. Let's use Charizard, actually. We haven't used Charizard. Okay. We just Amber on this Meowth. Meowth just ran in and Charizard just gained 354 experience points. Got a Rattata. Let's use Blastoise. No matter who, we'll be using Blastoise a lot when we do head up our next gym against Blaine. because he's actually is a foul type, so we still be just be able to go like right through him like easy peasy. A Blastoise is playing at the Rattata and he gained 292 experiment points. Got another Pidgey, which actually swap to Venusaur. Just bring all of these starters out. Just waste a leaf. Just one side this beautiful Venusaur. Beautiful. Pidgey just painted, and Venusaur has gained 282 experiment points. We got another Meowth here. Yeah, let's keep Venusaur out, actually. Let's just waste a leaf. We want my time on this Meowth. One side it. Beautiful. Critical hit. Meowth just painted, and Venusaur's gained 354 experiment points. Just defeated the Juno trainer female. Oh, I lost. It wasn't really much of a problem, to be honest. 480 Pokédollars for winning. I was really more. I don't think we actually do double Pokémon battles in this. I forget how to do now. Sure, I play with you, but I think more in the like, if I win in the game, I think this would be like a double Pokemon, or just a beauty. We haven't really fired beauty since the Obekas in Celadon City. It's GM actually. And we do have another beauty by next turn actually. Alright, double kick this Rattata Spanning, and he only just gained 328 experiment points. Got a Vulpix here. Let's keep him only out. Let's use strength. One shot this Vulpix. Beautiful him only. Which has gained 364 experiment points. Let's one shot this Rattata. Him only. We've been using strength. I think strength is more easy peasy. Once I just grab a Tata, and Emily just gained 328 experiment points. Oh, you little boot. Thank you for the 1890 Pokédollars beauty. I really do appreciate that. Alright, let's take out this beauty here. Do you want two Pokémon with me? If I gather per se battle, but Pokémon's fine. She has two, not four. I got a Clefairy. Yeah, we still do a double kick. Just one shot this Clefairy. And Hamelin just gained 421 experience points. And Hamelin just leveled up to level 38. Now Hamelin wants to try to learn a jump kick. Yes, we can actually swap it out. Gonna swap it out too. Yeah, we skip with a rolling kick. We haven't really did rolling kick a lot. Alright, Emily just long jump kick. Alright, she has a Meowth. Let's keep Emily out here. Let's use our new jump kick. Just one shot that Meowth. Meowth just painted and Emily just gained 427 experiment points. It's over already? Oh, see, actually got me more than the last beauty did. We got 2,030 Pokédollars for landing, actually. Sweet sign. Route 13, north to Silence Bridge. I've got a Juno trainer here. Wow, your bats are too cool. Well, thank you. I just need two more, actually. But I'm just going to go here for some training. Some experience. So, this junior trainer female actually have a Poliwag. We may need to start training Venusaur a little bit. Himalay just one shot that Poliwag, and Himalay just gained 495 experience points. Got another Poliwag here. Let's actually keep Himalay on the field and just jump kick. this level 30 party rag. Just one shot it. No problems at all. Emily's gained 495 experience points. Not enough. Thank you for the 600 Poké Dollars, actually. Let's go this way. Remember, there is a junior trainer right down there. I do want to read that sign with this beauties was actually standing at, actually. Oh, I did not know there was a bliss here. Okay. Trainer tips. Use secret to switch items in the item window. That's actually good to know. I'm actually curious if there's actually any items through this around this bush, this grass area. I don't think there's actually gonna be actually. I don't see any. Alright, let's go back out. I'm actually surprised if there actually is no. Trainers up there. I'm still with this junior trainer female here. My Pokemon wish to make your Accutate. I probably pronounced it wrong, but I kinda know what the word you're trying to say, junior trainer female. You got a Pidgey. Level 27 Pidgey here. Let's do a double kick. Not really affected, but we just painted the pigeon and it only just gained 318 experience points. Got Meowth, which actually swapped to Venusaur actually. Venusaur does need some experiences. It's just basically. One shot it. Beautiful Venusaur, beautiful. Just one shot that Meowth. Venusaur just gained 399 experience points. A junior trainer female is about to bring out a Pidgey. This has to keep Venusaur out. Just waste a leaf. One-sided. Critical hit. Not really effective, but we one-sided the Pidgey. And we Venusaur just gained 318 experience points. Her last Pokemon is a Pidgeotto. It's fine a bit. Just change it up just a slight bit. Alright, it's not. It doesn't one side. It didn't one side of it, but that's fine. It did manage to get this Pidgeotto to the orange though. Venusaur, Razor Leaf, attack, Gust. Pidgeotto's using Gust. PGO is using Quick Attack, and Venusaur is going to use Razor Leaf. Go ahead and faint this Pidgeotto. It's not really effective, but we just fainted it, the Pidgeotto, and Venusaur just gained 652 experience points. We do need to heal up Venusaur, actually. Wow, you totally won! Thank you for the 540 Poké Dollars for winning! That's a dead end now. We got a sign. Ooh, we got another trainer here. We got some trainers coming up. Let's read the sign. Trainer tips. Look to the left from the post. Look to the left from the post. Caquillium. Interesting. Thank you for the trainer tip, actually. We don't even know what this is, actually. What is this? It's usually on Venusaur. Oh, it's good for the specials. Okay, cool. Let's go ahead and heal up Venusaur. Like, for us, we only have two left, but we've been not really gonna have much of a problem going through these trainers, actually. So, let's go ahead and swap Venusaur to be up front now. Pretty much Venusaur and Pikachu is like the only low level Pokemon, at least on our team. Alright, we set up this trainer first. I always go with Bird Pokemon. Okay, we take Bird Keeper. It's four Pokemon. Ooh, we got a Pidgey. Alright, Venusaur. We've been one shotting all of our Pokemon so far. I know you can do it with Razor Leaf. It's one shot to Spidgey. Beautiful critical hit. It's not really affected, but we just painted the Pidgey, and Venus was just gained 306 apparent points. Got a Pidgey auto. Continue using Razor Leaf, Venusaur. We need to one shot these Pokemon. Oh, you could have one shot this Pidgeotto, but not a bit short, actually. Pidgeotto was about to use Whirlwind, but it's not really effective. We could use Vine Whip to feign it, but oh well. I like Razor Leaf anyway. Critical hit, but not really effective, but we just painted the Pidgeotto, and Venusaur just gained 628 experience points, and Venusaur just leveled up to level 37. Okay, we got a Sparrow. Yeah, let's continue using Razor Leaf. Beautiful critical hit. Beautiful one side Venusaur. And Venusaur just gained 322 experience points. The Boy Keeper is about to bring out his last Pokemon. It is a Pharaoh. It's actually going to keep Venusaur out. I'm going to use Razor Leaf and one shot this level 26 Pharaoh. The funny story, actually, the Pharaoh, we've been watching the Pokemon for juniors. There's a Braylon. Braylon's actually starting to get into Pokemon. And one of the, nursery rhymes, actually, a Pharaoh is actually supposed to be a turkey. It's kind of really interesting, actually. I said this whole time, I never really think of Pharaoh as a turkey, but okay, it is what it is. A Venusaur just painted this Pharaoh, and we just gained 901 experience points. Just defeated the Bookkeeper. Got outpowered. Thank you for the 650 Pokedollars, actually. I was continuing doing. Oh, this is a dead end, but we just found some pop points up. That's actually good on Pikachu, actually. We should actually use it on Pikachu because we definitely need a hit. No! Oh well. Fuck it. So cute. Alright. Alright, so this is a dead end. Let's go this way. We got a Bookkeeper up ahead. The wind's blowing my way. It's a Bookkeeper. I got a Sparrow. I kind of messed up using the power points up, but that is fine. Oh well, we've been messing up a lot. We're kind of getting over my head a little bit from pointing that stuff out. It was just one side that Sparrow. Venusaur just gained 310 experiment points. And the Bookkeeper was out to bring out a Pidgey, but that's gonna keep Venusaur out, actually. Yeah, back to what I was talking about the Pharaoh, actually. There was the nursery rhymes, they have the old McDonald, and it said turkey, and it came up as a Pharaoh. To me, I didn't really think of a Pharaoh as a turkey. But, okay. We just gained 424 experience points by fainting that Pidgey, but Spookkeeper about to bring out another Pidgey. We're gonna one-shot it. It's kinda insane, actually. I just can't really think of a Pharaoh as a turkey, though. It's a critical hit. It's not really effective, but it's a critical hit. It one-shotted this Pidgey. Venusaur just gained 294 experience points. We got another Sparrow here. Just continue one-shotting these. Venusaur, just keep one-shotting these. It's not every day I one-shotted it. Sparrow's about to use Leon. Just cut. Sparrow's life. Sparrow just fainted, and Venusaur just gained 310 experience points. Last Pokemon is another Sparrow. We should just find Mine Rope. We haven't been using Mine Rope. it's not really effective, but that's fine. Spell was about to use Leo, but it failed. Let's just line up one more time and see if we can actually faint the spell here. By pinch! Alright, spell is using Leo. Yeah, let's just use lazily. I can't believe that did not faint that spell without finding up. It's not really effective, but we just fainted the spell, and Venus will just gain 310 experiment points. The Wind Taunt. Thank you for the 625 Pokedollars, Bookkeeper, I really do appreciate that. What you looking at? Actually, I'm not looking at you, actually. I don't know why you say that. Biker? I was not expecting to be a biker this way. Man, you got coughing. Just changing it up a little bit. Alright. Putting all these bookkeepers to a biker. It's just basically from this coughing here. Can we one-shot this coughing? Oh, it's a critical hit, but it's not really effective. Alright, coughing is using tackle. It's just basically, we only have 3 more power points or PPs. Poor Razor Leaf. It's a critical hit, not really effective, but we just painted the coughing and Venus with this game. 684 experience points. Yeah, got another coughing. Let's just cut. It's not really affected. Coughing is about to use smug, but attack miss, which uses mind up. Coughing's not really a critical hit though. Coughing is using attack, just continue using mind up. Okay, it's a critical hit, but not really affected, but we did fainted this coughing. Venusaur just gained 684 experiment points. And Venus was just leveled up to level 38. I got one more Pokemon Venusaur. There's another coughing. I was used recently on this coughing. Come on, this is our second. We only got one left now. Oh, you could have one solid it. That's fine. Coughing is just in tackle. Just use cutting that little bit of health well from this coffin. Beautiful Venusaur, but just painted the coffin and Venusaur just gained 684 experience points. Dang! Strip gears! Got 560 Pokedollars for winning. Let's go this way. I feel like we may have to go back the other way. Oop. My bullet Pokemon should be ready to for battle. Well, we can't look like we can't go this way anyway, because that train is just blocking the owl way down from this gate path here. Yeah, this bookkeeper has a Pidgey. Let's just continue using Bimo. Actually, Bimo only have 4 power points left. Okay, it's not really affected. Pidgey about to use Whirlwind, but it wasn't effective. We may have to swap out, actually. What's up with you using Whirlwind? It's not really effective. Let's use Cut. You already tried it once, there's no need to use it again. A PG just made it and Venusaur just gained 306 spelling points. Alright, the Bookkeeper is about to bring out a Sparrow. Let's keep Venusaur out. Let's use Wyrmouth. This is Sassrias. It's not really effective. Alright, spell is using Leah. Let's use Vine Whip one more time and faint the spell. It did not faint it. The spell is using Fury Attack. It's not really doing a lot of damage, so I'm not too worried about it. It hit 5 times. Well, we can use Sky and just go ahead and faint the spell here. Venus will just gain 322 experience points, and Bookkeeper about to bring out another Pidgey. Yeah, we can't really do anything with Poison Powder, to be honest, but we do have one more power point with Razor Leaf, but we're just gonna continue to cut. Cut actually just faint one side of this Pidgey. I was not expecting that from Cut. Actually, Rhinosaur just gained 306 experience points. How really was nice about that? Alright, we got a failure here. The last Pokemon is the Tokibug. I can't believe it's a Toki, actually, according to Pokemon TV. Alright, didn't I once out of it, but it was close. Alright. Fail was using Fairy Attack. Alright, hit three times. Alright, it's just cut. We got 21 experience points. Well, we got 20 now. Alright, Fairy just fainted, and Venusaur just gained 901 experience points. Not ready yet. Thank you for the 650 Pokedollars, Bookkeeper. We do appreciate it. Alright, let's go back to zone this way. I feel like we should grab a bike and make this whole lot more quicker. Yeah, let's go ahead and heal up Venusaur while we at it. Okay. Bicycle. Let's make it a whole lot more faster. Let's see what this is. TMs are on sale in Celebon, but only a few people have TMs. I'm not so curious what this way takes us. We got a Bookkeeper here. We got a Pidgeotto. Alright, Venusaur. Let's use Razor Leaf. Come on, this is our last time using Razor Leaf. Critical hit, but we could have one side of there. Pidgeotto is just instant attack. Venusaur sensitivity just dropped. Okay, we should start using cut. We can't really do anything with poison powder, to be honest. Pidgeotto just painted and Venusaur just gained 702 experience points. Alright, he's bringing out Feral, the Tokibird. Which is gonna continue calling it the Tokibird, actually. It's not really doing a whole lot of damage, but that's fine. Hey, Fail is using Fairy Attack. Let's continue using Cut. Oh, it missed. Fail was about to use Mirror, and Fail was using Cut. Come on, Venusaur. Stop missing the attack, please. Alright, Fail is using Mirror. It's pretty much like Copycat, but I think actually Mirror actually changed out to Copycat. But Fail did miss his attack. Venusaur's cut his attack been missing. Fail is using Fury Attack. Man, it's so bad on Pokemon here. If cut does not go through this time. Alright, beautiful. It went through this time. Did not faint it, but that's fine. I feel was about to use Fairy Attack again, but the attack missed. We just cut one more time, Venusaur. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Fairy just faint it, and Venusaur just gained 1,006 experience points. And Venusaur just leveled up to level 39. Now, Venusaur is pretty much equal with the team now. Aw, bummer. Thank you for the 725 experience points, actually. Let's continue going this way. Oh, we got a Bookkeeper right up here, actually. Yes, actually. You need to use TMs to teach good moves to Pokemon. I do have some TMs in the PC, but there's nothing crazy for Pikachu or Venusaur or Charizard, actually. Use my Mipple Razor Leaf, but we just can be a fickle poison, or we can just cut. I don't know how a cut actually wants out of that Pidgey. Look, I think it's a spell of that one. Now, cut's not been doing any damage, but that's fine. My Pidgey just painted, and Venus just gained 330 experience points. Doduo. Ooh. I haven't seen these in a while, actually. We actually seen one of these when we actually was heading back to Pallet Town for the town map, actually. Around the time we would actually evolve Squirtle to Wartortle. And also when we get the bicycle episode, if you guys remember that. remember got done with Lieutenant Sword's gym, actually. Venusaur just painted this duo, and Venusaur just gained 576 experiment points. He got a Pidgeotto for the last Pokemon. Let's get some music cut. I was about to use Cinetic, but it failed. We only got 6 power points left. The only thing we could do now with Venusaur if we lose all these power points is just poison Pokemon pretty much. Venusaur just fainted the Pidgeotto and he gained 678 experiment points. Not good enough. Thank you for the 700 Pokedollars. But keep up, I really do appreciate it. Alright, let's continue going down this way. We've got a bookkeeper here. I see we wanted to read that sign. Have you taught your bug Pokemon how to fly? Actually, yes, I do. I have a Pidgeot. Do you want to see it, actually? They got 3 Pokemon. I got a Speller. You want to see my Pidgeot? You want to see my bug Pokemon? Alright, Venusaur. Let's actually swap out and read out Pidgeot here. My Pidgeot is a level 41. Alright, Speller was about to use a fairy attack. Hit 2 times. Alright, let's use Fly Pidgeot. See? I do have Fly. Well, Pidgeot misses attack. Pidgeot, what was that? What was that? Alright, that fairy attack just hit 3 times. Let's use Razor Wind. That was using another fairy attack. Critically hit. 2 times. 3 times. 4 times. 5 times. Hey. Beautiful. Could have once out of that spell. Oh yeah, my flyback. I can't believe it. Attack miss. Minus with this game 174 expand points and the same as Pidgeot. Let's keep Pidgeot out. Let's go ahead and use Fly again. See if we actually can be able to hit the attack this time. We're about to lose my controller actually. Beautiful Pidgeot. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Just painted the Dodrio and we just gained 576 experiment points. I'll be about to bring out the Togekiss. Let's use Fly. I was about to use Leah, but it failed. Take out the Turkey Bird. Oh, melee move. I could have hit Fly, it could have just failed. Uh oh. That's fine. Yeah, let's use Quick Attack. That didn't do too insane, to be honest. I fainted, Pidgeot just gained 972 experiment points. Shoot! Down in flames! Thank you for the 700 Pokedollars, Bookkeeper! I'm actually here to read the sign, actually. Route 14, west to Fossilia City! I feel like this is just gonna be a long... Ooh! Got a biker here! We ride out here because still more room! What, it's because this cycling road is too crowded for you? Like a dude. He has some coughing. Come on, Venusaur. Let's cut this. We only got 5 power points for cut. A coughing uses a smug. It's probably going to poison us. That's what he did. 9. Alright, we got 4 left. Oh, you could have fainted the coughing, Venusaur. Just a slight bit. That's fine. That is fine. Coughing just fainted, and Venusaur just gained 708 experiment points. He has a muck. A muck a muck. Okay. Let's use our last 2 cuts on this muck here. Well, it's not really effective against Venusaur muck by using that poison gas, but cut's not doing any damage. Yeah, he's about to use poison gas today. We can't even. We could use poison powder. This doesn't infect the monk, alright. We still have to hit Malene, because we can't really do anything with Venusaur, because monks is using disabled. Jump kick was disabled. Well, luck for you, we can just use strength. Critical hit! Mach disbanded, and Venus with this game 484 experiment points is a hit, only did 2. Alright, we do need a hit, swap out our Pokemon again. Wiped out! Thank you for the 580 Pokedollars, Spiker, I really appreciate that. We should be almost done with these routes, actually. We got a bookkeeper here. Have you heard of the legendary Pokemon? There's actually 4 we can actually catch, because actually in these old school Pokemon games, there's actually is not a Mew. Got a Felfetch. This actually was a glitch that we could have done earlier if I didn't know about it. If I knew about it, we could have gotten it earlier. But there was actually a glitch that we could have done before we actually managed to got down with Nugget Glitch before we actually hit like the first gym. Actually the first trainer to head into like Bill's house back in Zillion City. There was actually supposed to be a glitch that actually there was a trainer actually next to like the lake or the river where the Zillion City's caves is at. It's supposed to be like a glitch that you're best to do actually. Be able to get Mew. It was a glitch, but why I lost, but like Mew's actually really, really hard to get because actually Mew's not really like in-game Pokemon. The only thing you can be able to get Mew easily is by buying a accessory from Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu. We got a whole big wide of things here. We got some bikers right up here. Pokemon fight, Cool Rumble. Yeah, we can't really get Mew. Like, the only time you can be able to get Mew, it might be like a event. Or you can buy the accessory from that Pokemon controller thing from Let's Go Pikachu. Maybe you can be able to get Mew easily by doing that. We just one shot of that coughing him with this game. 708 experiment points. This bike has a gold lineman. Is that the only way you can be able to get Mew, actually? Alright, Glamour just made it, and Himalayas just gained 558 experience points. Himalayas just leveled up to level 39. Yeah, I'm gonna say pretty much every... blown away! We got 580 Pokedollars for winning. We got a biker here. I'm gonna make sure we actually get every single trainer to wear these routes, actually. Perfect! I need to burn some time. I want all the monies, that's all I'm worried about right now. Alright, the spiker has a cool lineman. I am really been pretty good with we had a power points for strength. It's just double kill. It's not really effective. It's not gonna have to use one move to faint this cool lineman. Let's use double kick one more time. That is fine. It's not really effective, but we just painted the Glimmer. Himalayas just gained 540 experiment points. The only Pokemon's legendary Pokemon we can be able to get is Mewtwo! And the 3 legendary boards. It's Articuno, Moltres, and Zapdos. We get Articuno from Seafoam Islands. That's pretty much where we're gonna be heading at in the next episode, actually. Because we do have to go through Seafoam Island to get across those little islands to get to settle their island, actually. We just painted the Glimmer and Hitmonlee just gained 540 experience points. I think the Yasmin can be able to encounter Articuno now, actually. because we got pretty much all of the TMs. But I believe more in the recent games, you had to get like rock climb and stuff like that. Skull Bash is disabled, which used Jump Kick. And we all know what Zapdos is at. Zapdos is in the power plant around the rock tunnel area. I think so we can actually fly to that Pokemon Center, if I believe so myself. Alright, Koffing just fainted, and Hitmonlee just gained 684 experiment points. I know you could in Let's Go Pikachu Navy. What? You? Got $560 for winning. Alright, we got a tree here, just to an area of grass. Alright, we got a biker here. Come on, let's go! And Moltres is actually... it's on Victory Road, actually. A little bit off of Victory Road, but it's pretty much on Victory Road. Alright, we get Koffing. Let's just double kick. Oh, you could've won some of that Koffing, Hitmonlee. Could've won some of it. That is fine. We just painted that Koffing, Hitmonlee just gained 634 experience points. Got Koffing. And Mewtwo's gonna be in our Shilin's cave. And Mewtwo, I can say, is actually the hardest Pokemon to be able to catch. The reason why I actually want to get every single money from each champ, because we need to make sure we buy a lot of Ultra Balls, actually. I know I didn't say the last experiment points is from the last Koffing, but that is fine. Swansorted that, not really Swansorted the Glamourith, but just fainted the Glamourith, and Hitmonlee just gained 501 experiment points. Alright, we got Koffing. Should be close to Fulcia City now, because whenever we do head back to Fulcia City, we make sure we hit the Pokemon Center. Make sure we actually get our Pokemon heal up and power points back up before we start heading to our next city, our next objective. Hitmonlee just fainted the Koffing, and Hitmonlee just gained 634 experience points. Ugh, lost. Get lost. Thank you for the 520 Pokedollars, Biker. I really do appreciate that. There was a biker that way, but not gonna worry about him. Oh, we got some beauties here. Oh, you a little kitty. Thank you. I really do appreciate that. Beauty. You got two Pokemon, you got a PTO though. Probably the other one's probably like a Meowth or something. Sugar Boots want to come and join. Let's just jump kick on this Pidgeotto. Pidgeotto is going to attack for us and use a quick attack. One-sided. Beautiful Hitmonlee. Beautiful. Pidgeotto just fainted and Hitmonlee just gained 702 experiment points. Hitmonlee just leveled up to level 40. And that was a Wigglytuff. I was actually in surprises now. Meowth. Let's just jump kick on this Wigglytuff here. Can we one shot it? Beautiful one shot on this Wigglytuff. And Hitmonlee just gained 676 experience points. You look so cute too. Well, thank you for the 2030 Pokedollars, actually. You look gentle, so I think I can beat you. Actually, my Pokemon is just a top-notch beauty, just saying. Oh, it's not a beauty, it's actually a junior trainer female, actually. Alright, we got a Pidgey. Still jump kick on this Pidgey. Oh, jump kick missed. Alright, Hitmonlee's keep going in quest. Oh, that's actually kind of lit there. Hitmonlee just continue going, but questing it actually hurt. Beautiful, just one side of the Pidgey. Why should you jump kick again? And Pidgey just painted, and Hitmonlee gained 340 experiment points. about to bring out my Pidgeotto. Just jump kick. Survive it. Beautiful, Emily. One shot that Pidgeotto. Pidgeotto just fainted, and Emily just gained 702 experience points. No! Wong, thank you for the 580 Pokédollars, Junior Trainer. I really do appreciate that. We got some bikers here. Hey kid, come on! I just got this! Okay, I wasn't trying to crash you, biker, but okay. This guy has 5 Pokémon. Oh, you got coughing. Alright, Himalay, which one saw these coughings? Aw, just a bit sore. Coughing's just a smug. Uh-oh. Emily's poisoned. Alright, she's just jump kick. Alright, coughing just fainted. And Emily just gained 610 experience points. The biker's back to bring another coughing out. It's actually swap out to Charizard, that's why. I haven't used Charizard in a little bit. Let's just slash. Once on it. Oh, just by a pinch. Coughing's using smug. Let's just slash one more time on this coughing. Coughing just fainted, and Charizard just gained 610 experience points. Got Weezling. It's just last. Which one's at this Weezling, Charizard? I know you can. Aw, come on, Charizard. I know you could one shot at it. Weezling's using Sludge. Surprised it did not poison us, though, but that's fine. It's a critical hit by using Slash and just painted Weezling, and Charizard just gained 925 experience points. Got another coughing here. It's just Amber. I could have one shot it. Alright, coughing's using Taco. Let's just Amber one more time. Critical hit. Coughing just fainted, and Charizard just gained 610 experience points. Alright, Slash Pokemon is a Grimer. There's Amber. Charizard's attack missed. Come on, Charizard. Let's use Amber. One shot it. What's up with you not one summoning these Pokemon, Charizard? Critical hit. Alright, Glamour just fainted, and Charizard just gained 481 experience points. Why not? Thank you for the 500 Pokédollars, Biker. I really do appreciate that. Come on, Biker, bring it on. Fuck over all your casts when you lose to me, kid. Actually, I'm gonna be the one that gonna win, Biker. Now you got coughing. We're looking for you, my Emily is poison and on level only on training 1 health. But we're gonna do double kick on this coughing and see where I can come on Emily, you could one shot of it. That's fine. My Emily just got hurt by poison. Smug, cuff, but I'm cuffing, and that's actually gonna be my health to 9. Let's use double kick. Can we faint it? Oh, yeah, it's not really effective, but it's just fainted the coughing. Himalay just gained 684 experience points. I got a Golimo here. Yeah, let's swap it out to Blastoise. We need to make sure we actually cure that poison. Alright, Blastoise is using Surf. It changes a lot to the future games, actually. One shot the Glimmer, and Blastoise is gained 540 experience points. We got a Weezling. Alright, let's use Surf. I kinda wish Surf with more power points, to be honest. I know I kind of overdoing stuff, but that is fine. Recently expanded and Blastoise this game 1038 expand points. That can't be true. Thank you for the 560 Poké Dollars. I know you have more, Biker. Right, we got some more beauty here. Right, let's cure him away here. I think I already used all of my potions. No, we got a junior trainer. Junior trainer female here. Let me try out the Pokemon I just got in the a trade. What is the Pokemon you just got it from a trade, junior trainer? We got Gloom. Double kick. Come on, Emily. I know you can do a whole lot more better than that. Emily just double kick twice. Gloom's using stun score. Emily's just got paralyzed. She's jumping up. Gloom's using the acid. Gloom is actually a whole lot. Well, Emily just fainted. That's fine. I had a feeling that Emily was gonna faint anyway. Let's use Charizard. Is Gloom's the Pokemon you actually got from trading, or is it any of the other Pokemon you just got? Gloom just fainted and Charizard just gained 792 experiment points. Joshua just leveled up to level 39. Or maybe it's an Oddish. Let's go ahead and use Emma. We can one-shot this. Again, beautiful Joshua. Just one-shot that Oddish. Joshua just gained 468 experience points. And Junior Trainer is about to bring out the other Oddish. It has to be Gloom. Just need a Vine Bloom pretty much. Because Vine Bloom is like the only Oddish is a sleeping battle. Uh oh, Charizard just fell asleep. Well, Oddish is painted by Bond and Charizard just gained 468 spam points just because Charizard's asleep. Alright, cool. Not good enough. Think of it 560 Poké Dollars actually. And we got a sign here. Route 15, let's to Fossilia City. I think this is a youngster, I can't really tell. Oh, it's a bullet keeper. My bullets are serving you good, ain't you? We should be close to Fossilia City by now. Cause this is actually the last route. Alright, we did lost. What was the Doduila? The above form of... I can't do anything with the Venusaur. I don't know why Venusaur is still in the lead by now. I wish to change out the Pidgeot, actually. This is probably gonna be the longest episode that I did throughout the series, because I kinda know, like, this is gonna be, like, a real long episode, because I just wanna do this in one episode, actually. So, just letting you guys know if you guys have made it this far throughout the episode. Doduo's using Fairy Attack. Only hit one time. We could've one-shotted that. Well, we're gonna use Quick Attack. Pidgeot. We could've one-shotted this Doduo, but that's fine. Fairy just gained 474 experiment points, and Pidgeot did too. Bag Doduo. Let's just fly. Let's one-shot at this time, Pidgeot. One-shot it, please. Beautiful Pidgeot, beautiful. Doduo just fainted and Pidgeot just gained 576 experience points. Got one Pokemon was, it's a Doduo. I was doing the same thing, Pidgeot. Same exact thing, not a problem at all. Alright, Doduo is using Fairy Attack, but it missed. One shot it. Beautiful Pidgeot, beautiful. Alright, Pidgeot just gained 576 experience points. And Pidgeot just leveled up to level 42. Beautiful Pidgeot, beautiful. Alright, just as I thought. Thank you for the 700 Poké Dollars, Bookkeeper. Okay, let's actually swap Pidgeot. Pidgeot or Blastoise? Or just Charizard? Yeah, I was thinking of Pidgeot, actually. We do need to wake up Charizard. So let's go ahead and do that now. We can use our revives on him only. I just don't have potions to heal all of our Pokemon back to full health. Alright, we got a Bookkeeper here. When I whistled, I came summon birds. Pokemon. We got four Pokemon. We got a Pidgeotto here. Alright, Pidgeot. You know what to do. Just make sure we actually one-shot these old Pokemon. We're using Quick Attack. We could have one-shot the Pidgeotto. Pidgeotto was about to use Whirlwind, but it was not really effective. Alright, beautiful Pidgeotto. I mean, Pidgeot. Pidgeotto just fainted, and Pidgeot just gained 628 experience points. Alright, got a Felfetch. Let's keep Pidgeot out. Let's just fly. Pidgeot about to use Leo, but it failed. Pidgeot using a fly with one such as Farfetch. Farfetch is fainted, and Pidgeot. Pidgeot just gained 523 experience points. Oh, look at Doduro. Okay, it's just flying. Doduro is using Fury Attack, but it missed. Pidgeot is gonna use Fly, but once that's just Doduro. Doduro just fainted, and Pidgeot just gained 534 experience points. I've got one more Pokemon, it is a Pidgey. Just waste a win. Pidgey's using Quick Attack. We're gonna use Waze Win. One shot this Pidgey. Beautiful Pidgeot. Beautiful. Pidgey just fainted, and Pidgeot just gained 360 spelling points. Wow, that's tragic. Thank you for the 650 Pokédollars, Bookkeeper. I really do appreciate that. We got a junior trainer. I think this is actually the last trainer in the route. Want to play with my Pokémon? I feel like this has to be the last trainer in the, on this long route of ours. It was actually was between the, this route or Cycling Road. From, Sivuan City, actually, but I'm just thinking like we should just one solid that Bellsprout Pidgeot. Think about the 522 experience points. Got an artist. So use Wing Attack. One solid the artist. Super effective. Pidgeot just gained 484 experience points. Got one more, is a Tangela. I haven't seen a Tangela in a minute. I've got, I'm gonna use Wing Attack once at this Tangela. That's right, did not one side of it. My Tangela is using Vine Mode. It's not really effective, but. Could have one side of it, Pidgeot. Could have one side of that Tangela, but that's fine. Pidgeot just gained 1030 experience points upon that Tangela. I was too impatient. Got 580 Pokédollars for winning. Oh yeah, baby. That was the last trainer in Route 15. And now we are back in Felucia City. Now I'm gonna go ahead and do one more thing actually. We're gonna head up to the Pokemon Center. We need to make sure we actually do heal up a Pokemon before our next adventure. We'll be heading our way to Sildon Island. I mean, we're gonna be surfing, gonna be dealing with a lot of water type Pokemon. Go ahead and heal up. I'm kind of sorry that this episode was the most longest episode out throughout the whole series, but I just want to do that whole 3 to 4 routes in one go, actually. So, we're gonna go ahead and end this one here, guys. Hope you guys did enjoy this episode. If you guys are liking the series so far, hit that like button. Hit that subscribe button. Also, ding dong the bell. I'm gonna just draw my good ward. And my old ward, actually. I think I already did my old ward, actually. Yes, I did. Alright, cool. Alright, I'll see you guys in the next one. Before we actually do head up to Seafoam to Celadon Island, we might actually want to head up the Pokemon Market before we go back on the road. Gonna be taking Soph in the next episode. See you guys in the next one. Peace, guys.